Good morning, you're listening to FloridaDaily.net, and I'm Kemp Haar. This morning, my guest is Jeff Gordon, the Executive Director with the Fuse Flooring Alliance. Jeff, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Kemp.
I wanted to catch up with you on several things. It's been about 6 weeks since we've talked. I know you're out there in California. You woke up on Flying Cloud Drive. That sounds like a great place to be.
Yes, it's beautiful, I will say.
Yeah, most people know the Fuse Alliance is a network of, what do you have now, about 100 members that are flooring contractors. What's the count now?
We're now up to 127.
127. You added three new members.
Yes, we added three new members in the last month and a half.
Mm-hmm. Why do you think people are joining right now?
You know, with the COVID situation and the effects on the economy and the product changes, you know, going heavier to LVT and resilient, you know, all those types of things have independent companies looking for sources where they can be tuned into what's happening. You know, I go back when I ran a flooring contractor business, you feel like you're in your own little bubble, and it's nice to be part of a group with shared practices.
Right. So let's talk about the health of the membership. Tell us what's going on at the collective group of Fuse Flooring Contractors.
Well, the timing of this call, Kemp, is very good because we do calls with the membership and the board every 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And so our calls were Tuesday and Wednesday of last week, and I expected some negativity with, you know, the increase we've seen in the COVID cases and everything else. But our members overall are very optimistic, and, you know, they're having better years than they thought they were going to have. You know, that's number one. And number two, they have very large backlog from the bidding they had done in the past, and maybe some of the jobs had been delayed. But now they're going, and I would say, I don't know, 40%, maybe a little more of our members are reporting that they could possibly have a bigger year this year than last year.
Well, that's good to hear, and I think the backlog is driving most of that. What's their outlook? Maybe this will last until the end of this year. Then what's the outlook for next year?
I get different feedback on that, Kemp. I mean, some people are bullish for 2021 because they booked work, but there's a little bit of a concern about business 6 months from now. You know, we talk a lot about the Architectural Billings Index, for an example, which has been down, and that's basically our pipeline.
Right.
So, you know, we see a time where we think things will get slower, but I was talking to a member the other day. He's like, oh, Jeff, it's really gotten quiet, and then all of a sudden I got word we're going to get a contract for a $4 million job, so we're fine. We're in an uncertain time, but overall, everybody feels pretty good.
All right. So they're changing some of the things they do now, right? I mean, we've talked before about the janitorial disinfectant surfaces. Some of the people are doing that. And you're telling me that some of them now are also in the business of hanging plexiglass. Is that right?
Customers ask for certain things. And, you know, the plexiglass industry, as you know, has had a huge resurgence with all the measures we're taking for social distancing. So some of our members have started to offer that, which began as a request from their customers, and we've been spreading the word, and it's a relatively easy thing to add on to a job when you have people already in the field. So, yes, that's become part of some of our members' work.
How often does your board talk?
It's every 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Yep.
And you've got George Spanke. He's the president now, right?
George Spanke is the president, yes.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. And y'all have decided now some interesting news. You've decided that in light of everything, you're not going to have your meeting next year. Is that right?
Yeah, that was a really tough decision. As you know, we do our national meetings. We do one major meeting a year. It's always the first week of March. Mm-hmm. And we were scheduled to be in Dallas in 2021.
Yeah.
But with everything that's going on in COVID, and, you know, most things have been canceled in 2020, and now I'm hearing things being canceled in the first quarter of 21. We just felt at the end of the day, it was not risky, that's the wrong word, but this just didn't make good business sense to keep that meeting set for that date. I mean, the worst thing you could do is plan a major event and then have a lot of members that aren't comfortable in coming.
Well, it's interesting you make this decision. You were actually the last meeting that I attended, so you got one in right before all hell broke loose.
Right.
Yeah.
And you know, Kemp, our thinking is, let's say a vaccine comes along, which would be wonderful. It's going to take a while for that to be implemented, of course.
Right.
But if things start to get back to normal early next year, then we'll substitute for the meeting some regional meetings around the country. So we'll definitely do something. And then I would add, too, if the situation isn't that great next year, we'll end up putting together a virtual meeting.
Well, I'm hearing mixed reviews on that. Some people think that it falls way short of the real deal.
Well, the networking is so important. But then the other way we look at it, the connection to our members and for the members to stay connected is so important, too. So we have to keep pushing that envelope because we don't want to lose the contact, not only between us and the members, but between the members and each other.
Yeah. Tell me about the supply side with your vendor partners. You got continuity of supply? I mean, you got vendors that are getting you members the product they need?
You know, I'm not hearing any issues with supply. I mean, I know some of the companies had let us know that they were cutting back inventories, and so there'd be order dates extended. But whatever dates we're getting, whether it's 4 weeks, 6 weeks, or 8 weeks, they seem to be meeting those requirements. So, you know, as far as I can tell, we're doing just fine.
Mm-hmm. Well, isn't it interesting, in April started looking at all this, it sounded like the sky was falling, and now you're telling me the members are doing okay. So, you know, while there's this serious threat of people getting the virus, business is getting done, isn't it?
You know, I think a lot of it, you go to a worst-case scenario, and, you know, we were preparing for that, you know, looking at, you know, how much could our numbers be impacted by 20 or 25%.
Yeah.
And luckily, it's been nowhere near that. So I think the general vibe is, we're doing much better than we would have thought. And then remember, too, you know, a lot of companies, flooring contractor companies, got access to the PPP loan,
right,
which, you know, definitely have helped bridge the gap in a time where business has slowed down.
Mm-hmm. And the word on that is that most people are going to, that's probably going to be forgiven, right?
Yes. As optimistic as we are, mm-hmm, our businesses have been impacted.
That's right. But they'll survive to be here on the other end, right?
Absolutely.
All right, Jeff, great to talk to you. Thanks for giving us an update on what's going on with your membership. Again, been talking to Jeff Gordon, Executive Director with the Fuse Flooring Alliance, and you've been listening to Kempar and FloorDaily.net.